Before I talk to you about Fancy Friday, I need to say some big hellos. So hello to my daddy. I love you so much. He is the reason behind me doing my Fancy Fridays. He is my biggest fan. And hello, Judy. She always makes sure that that my dad watches this, and she is a big fan of mine as well. And Lisa, she's my best friend. And Aunt Donna. She's the best aunt ever. All right, so thank you so much to all of you who watch my Fancy Fridays. I really, really do appreciate it. All right, so let's start talking about Fancy Friday and what it is. All right, so it's a pretty simple concept. I found a day, Fridays, that I like to get fancy and dress up in my fancy clothes and just kind of have the day where I'm fancy. And then I thought I would start recording it, and you could see what fancy clothes I was wearing, and we would talk about what Fancy Friday really is, because it's about way more than clothes. Fancy clothes or otherwise, right? Yeah. Okay, so as I started doing my Fancy Fridays, I realized that there was kind of a theme here. A lot of us are saving things, probably fancy things, for a better time or someone else. And I started to realize that we need to stop doing that, okay? I went into my closet when I decided I just wanted to start being fancy, and I was going to do it whether I had anywhere to go or not. I had a lot of gowns with their tags still on them, and I realized that I was waiting for the right time or the right event or whatever to dress up when I didn't need to do that. And we do that with a lot of things, okay? We do that with our china, our good glasses, our towels, our tablecloths, our candles. Think about it. Do you have things that you save that are not for every day? Things that you save and you only bring out when someone special is coming over. Even if it's just guests, they're special, right? Or a special time. And then you start thinking, you know what? I really like those. And they make me so happy and they make me smile, but I'm not using them. And that's the problem. They're for you. You bought them. They make you happy. You need to start using them. That's really what it's all about. So as you start listening to me and spend some time with me, I hope that I help you to remember that life is way too short to save things for other people or other times, and that your life can be richer by using those things when you want to. Pull out the beautiful, beautiful wine glasses that you have and your beautiful candle, and get dressed up and sit at your dining room table all by yourself if you don't have anybody else, and take it in. Just take it in. Use the things that make you smile, and you'll realize that you're smiling so much more because you're using the things you love. And start doing that once a week, once a month. Don't cheat yourself out of those things. And that's what we're doing when we are saving them for other times, or what we consider better times, or other people. Start thinking about you, yourself, and start using them for you. It doesn't mean you can't use them for your guests too. It means you gotta stop saving them for other people, and you need to start using them because you bought them because you loved them. And they make you smile. End of story. Okay, so now it's time to show you my outfit that I'm wearing. This is kind of an understated fancy. I've showed you this little black dress before, but I decided to cinch it with this belt, and you really can't see it except for the belt buckle, but I kind of feel like that accentuates the waist that I don't have. And I went very simple with a red necklace. And then I'm going to try to turn this, and you can see my red booties, my suede red booties. I've had these for a while, and I absolutely love them. And then I figured, I got to get the cat off this piece. Come on, baby. That I'd add this to it, too. So this is a really nice dress. You can wear out, and you can get it a little more fancier with this. This is one of my favorite sweaters. Lisa just mentioned to me the other day that she missed seeing the sweater and she hadn't seen it in a while. So I thought I would break it out. I bought it, it was very impractical. And I was like, you know what? I'm just gonna use it. And that goes along with what I was saying about Fancy Friday. Start using the things that you love and the things that make you happy and make you what? Smile! Alright, so now it is time to show you my favorite products. And today I have two favorite products, and both of them are related to medication. Sounds kind of weird, right? Okay, so number one, magnesium glycinate. Did you know that most people, especially women, but most people are low on magnesium? And did you know that there's like five different kinds of magnesium? So people are kind of like, what should I take? I don't know what the others are for, except I do know there's a lot of magnesium that are for when you're constipated. So be prepared if you're not constipated and you get one of those others, be prepared for having diarrhea. Unfortunately, I know that's true. I know before one of my surgeries, I had to go get one of those before my surgery and clean myself out a little bit. Sorry if that's TMI. So make sure you get the glycinate, and I take four of them a day. I take them at night. They help me sleep, and they have taken my night sweats completely away. I'm still hot at night, but I'm not waking up covered in sweat. And if you've ever had that happen, you know how annoying that is. So this helps a lot, like some with sleep. There's a lot of other things it helps with, and you can look it up, but that's what I take for magnesium glycinate. And you can get the magnesium just about anywhere that has over-the-counter medication. I get mine from Amazon, but I get just about everything from Amazon, right? Okay. All right, so this is a bottle, and it's comes in a package of like four bottles that my daughter got me for Christmas. And let me tell you why she gave it to me first. Have you ever had this happen, or maybe it's just me, I doubt it since these were made for this, where you're in the afternoon, you're like, did I take my pills this morning? And you don't want to double them, because there's some medications I cannot double. That would be really bad if I doubled them. So it's like, I can't double them, but I can't remember if I took them. Or I take meds at night, it's the same thing. I get myself ready for bed, I'm like, oh shoot, did I take my medication? This little bottle, the bottle cap, comes with the bottles and the bottle cap, and it comes with another thing that will baby-proof them, but or child-proof them, whatever. Anyway, when you use it, undo, screw it, you put your meds in here, and then you put this on, okay, and the battery's out in this one, but it will automatically say a one, say like sec one or something like that, and it will count down. So when you go to look at it later, you're like, okay, it says 24 hours. So if it says 24 hours, you know that you didn't take them today, right? And so you can see this one, the battery's there, it's counting down, okay? It will stop counting down at 99 hours. So if it is blank, either the battery went dead, which is very easy to check, or it's been a long time since you took your meds. So they come in different colors, so you can kind of figure different color lids, so you can figure out, you know, which med. I have a lot of meds I take, so I just use one for one med I take in the morning and one for a med that I take at night. So it helps me to remember. And I can very easily look at this number and go, oh yeah, I did take my meds today. Thank you. Or, no, I didn't take them. So I really like this product. My daughter bought it at Amazon, I believe, but I know you could probably get them elsewhere. If you're interested, just let me know and I can look them up or have her, you know, tell me. I don't know, you know, what the brand name is or anything, but she had been telling me for a while she was going to get those because she would always hear me say, oh my gosh, did I take my meds? I can't remember. And my memory is just horrible. So this is a really good thing if you take daily meds and you forget things about your meds. All right, so this is the end of Fancy Friday. Oh, and this is the end of February Fancy Friday. There will not be another Fancy February Fancy Friday in 2024. Next week it will be March, which is absolutely stinking crazy, right? Alright, so, anyway, I hope you had a wonderful time watching this video. I hope that you have an awesome Friday, and that you have an even better weekend, and I hope that this video helped you in some way. And if it did, I'd love to hear from you, and may you have a fancy Friday and a fancy week. Bye-bye. Love you. Bye, Daddy. Love you. Judy, Lisa, Aunt Donna.